Well, his name may not be as familiar as Donald Trump's, but Wisconsin Governor Scott Walker is one of the leaders in the polls among the crowded Republican presidential field. David Brody spent time with him in Iowa this weekend for his views on the issues and how he'd act as president.
I believe in America. I love America.
Scott Walker may come across as an average guy, but he's ready to aim much higher.
I'm Scott Walker. I'm running for president. I'm asking for your vote.
Early poll numbers put the Wisconsin governor in the top tier of a very crowded Republican field. His campaign message? Reform, growth, safety.
If you made a list of common sense conservative reforms in this country, I don't think you could point to one that we haven't accomplished across the way in Wisconsin, a blue state.
That's Walker's claim to fame, a conservative governor getting results in a state that has not voted Republican for a president, at least, in more than 30 years. He's also battle-tested, winning re-election and overcoming a nasty recall effort brought on by liberals and public unions. He's built a tough reputation, even writing a book called Unintimidated. His critics think he won't compromise at all.
Some folks will say unintimidated means I'm not going to compromise. And yeah, I know you're a student of history.
Yeah.
Ronald Reagan, the 80-20 model.
Right.
Do you subscribe to something along those lines?
Well, I don't think you should never compromise your principles. Mm-hmm. But in terms of the details, I mean, I think as governor, you know, when I pushed for the stuff that probably most people know me about, which was taking on the unions, I wanted 100% repeal of collective bargaining. We tweaked it a little bit. As long as you don't compromise your principles, the details, you can always work that out.
A pro-life candidate, Walker wants to strip federal funding from Planned Parenthood. And he's called the Supreme Court decision on same-sex marriage a grave mistake. And he wants a constitutional amendment allowing states to define the issue, not the courts. Then a media report implied that he and his wife might take opposite sides on the marriage issue. Walker quickly cleared up any confusion.
My wife actually supports my position, so that's something. She pointed out she was torn by the fact that she's got me with a position and she's got other family members with a different position. But being emotionally torn doesn't mean that she's got a difference of opinion.
And Walker's record shows he's no pushover. He told me that as President Walker, he would display that no-nonsense approach from day one.
I'd speak out and take an active, aggressive position to call on the Congress to fully repeal Obamacare and put patients and families back in charge and actually send up draft legislation to empower them to do that.
Mm-hmm.
I'd pull back on day one on the bad Iran deal we just talked about. And I, going forward, would make sure that we pulled back on so many of the other bad regulations under this president.
Walker wants everything he does to be grounded in his faith. As the son of a Baptist preacher, he knows a thing or two about the Bible.
You know, one of the scriptures I find to be most comforting is in 2 Corinthians 12:9, where Paul talks about the thorn in his flesh and speaks the words of Christ saying, "My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness." And it's just such a powerful, powerful reminder that no matter how challenging times are, his grace is more than sufficient.
That's something he'll need in what is shaping up as a long and crowded campaign. David Brody, CBN News, in Cedar Rapids, Iowa.